thank you this morning. We worship you, Holy Spirit. We give you all the glory and adoration. We reverence you. We give you all the honor in the name of Jesus Christ. You are the Lord. Let your name be glorified. You are the Lord. Let your name be glorified. As we give you glory and honor, you are the Lord. Let your name be glorified. You are the Lord. Let your name be glorified in this place. You are the Lord. Let your name be glorified. Daddy, as we give you glory and honor, you are the Lord. Let your name be glorified. God bless you. God bless you. In the name of Jesus, I just want to thank you this hour. We are here again on this marathon prayers that we do every day. We do day and night. God bless you. The word for us today is how to be intimate with God. 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 I just want you to share this on your wall as you get on. Share it with your family members, friends, whoever is available. Connect with them and let's lift the name of Jesus high. Let us pray. The Bible says the entrance of the word bringeth light and understanding to the simple. Lord, your word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. Let the word that we are hearing and speaking now not be an enticing word of a man, but let it be the word of God that will bring glory to thy holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. How to be intimate with God. Jesus said something. I want to give us the word before we tell you what it is. Luke chapter 18, if you read from verse 1 to 7, but I'm just going to read verse 1 and verse 7. Jesus said, men ought to always pray and not faint. So prayer is the key to be intimate with God. But we have two kinds of prayer that I'm going to explain in a minute. You look at verse 7. And shall not God avenge? He's talking about a woman. Men ought to pray and not faint. And he went straight to a woman that came to a judge that has no fear for God or man. The Bible said the woman came and said, come and avenge for me, they have taken my land. And this woman was a widow, and the judge did not respond, but the woman kept coming. Up till verse 6, the Bible said the judge said, if I don't help this woman, she will not let me rest. I'm just going to go and avenge and help her. And the judge did. And Jesus said in verse 7, and shall not God avenge his own elect, the children of God, which cry day and night. The prayer with God has to be twice a day, day and night, unto him, though he bear long with them. And shall not God avenge his own, which cry day and night, though he bear long with them? So what brings us closeness to God? The intimacy that we have with God is through prayer. And prayer is divided into two. There are many kinds of prayer, but prayer is divided into two. There's a prayer of demanding, which everybody's familiar with. You go, God, give me house, give me husband, give me. Help me. That is not what we are talking about today. We are talking about the second part of prayer, which is the prayer of intimacy. The prayer when you get in the presence of God, you don't remember to ask for your rent. You say, Father, I thank you for loving me. I thank you for creating me. I thank you for allowing me to be alive today. I worship, I reference you. You just go and worship God. You adore him. You love on him. In the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 6, verse 5, the Bible says, love the Lord with all your heart, with all your might, and with all your soul. Just go and love God. You forget that you have needs. You just go. Sometimes God wants us to love on him. God wants, we are in a relationship with God, and the relationship is a spiritual relationship. Even in a physical relationship, if we don't show love sometime, the relationship will begin to go south. God wants us to love him. It's not a time to come and say, God, oh, I need you to heal me. All those things will be taken care of once we begin to show love. In intimacy, we begin to go spirit to spirit. The book of Psalm 42 talk about deep, calling unto deep. You go deep with God. You don't go shallow. You don't go shadow. You go deep. It is a deep relationship. You say, God, I love you, I love you, I love you. And you begin to speak all your heart. Intimacy with God. As we go intimate with our wives and husband, God expects us to come and have intimacy with him. Many times when you have a husband, a partner, or a wife, it's not every time that you keep talking about the things that you will do and the things you have not done. Sometimes you just sit down and look at each other and have a good meal and say, oh, you are beautiful, you are wonderful. Oh, you start to talk about good qualities that both of you share, and you forget that sometimes things are hard with your family. You forget that sometimes things, and many times when we get into that intimacy place, then you start to see the blessings come out. Intimacy releases everything. Once you can get the face of God, you can get his wallet. If you can get his face, you can get his bank account. If you can get his face, you can get the treasure. So intimacy is the greatest way to be able to love on God and show appreciation for even creating you. Sometimes people say, oh, God has not given me all the things I asked for. Go and love on him. Hallelujah. So we go in a prayer of intimacy. First Peter. Peter said in the book of First Peter, hallelujah, Lakoto Shakatama, verse chapter 4, verse 7. He said, but the end of all things is at hand. Be sober, ye therefore, and watch unto prayers. The end of all things is at hand. Be ye therefore sober and watch unto prayer. Be you also sober and watch unto prayer. Intimacy with God is everything. God wants to love on you, and God wants you to love on him. God wants to have an intimacy. Knowing God is nothing but intimacy. When you say you know God, that means you have been with him in an intimate way. You can't know God from the books. You don't know God from reading the word, but you, as you read the word and meditate, the word will take you into that place of love, the place of appreciation, the place of worship, the place where you start to allow God to flow in you, to flow with you. You don't read about God and you say you know him. That is head knowledge. Knowledge, when we talk about knowledge, we are talking about information. You don't get God by information, you get him by feeling. The feelings that you have in him. That's why professors are not in church. That's why people that have PhDs in different methodologies, people that even have PhD in Bible studies, they don't understand that God is a spirit, and they that must serve him in truth and in spirit. And God is not a Father Christmas. That when we go to God every day, we just say, Father, oh, come on, heal my daughter, my son, my wife, give me money and all that. When we do the needy, the necessary things, all these things will be added. Jesus said, Lakatasikoto, Matthew chapter 6, 33. He says, seek you first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. The prayer of intimacy, a prayer room, a place where you go and be intimate with God, where you go and love on God, where you go and reverence God, adore him, where you go and take, God, Father, I thank you for life. I thank you for creating me. You don't ask anything. You need some things, but you say, I thank you for what you have done in my life. I thank you. I thank you. I thank you. As we continue to thank God and begin to thank him, things will begin to work in our favor. Things will begin to work for us. Things will begin to work the way we want it, because God is a spirit. And the Bible said, they that must serve him in truth and in spirit, in the name of Jesus Christ. Rakoto Sokotobo. Thanksgiving, the Bible said in the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 18. In the name of Jesus Christ. 1 Thessalonians 5, 18. Look at what the Bible says here. In everything, not some things, in everything, whether somebody has died, you are sick in your body, you lost your job, God said, in everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. This is the will of God. The will of God is that you thank him. You thank him for life. You thank him for health. You thank him for everything. Intimacy. As you continue to thank God for the things that you didn't have, God will begin to make them happen for you. In the name of Jesus, when Jesus was faced with challenges, he did not complain and say, God, what is happening? The Bible says Jesus came to the tomb of a man that died. Lazarus was dead. And as you know it, when somebody died, they don't come back to life. The body will shut down. But the Bible says, Jesus said, Father, I thank you for glorifying your name in me. And he called him forth. He said, Lazarus, come forth. Thanksgiving brought the miracle of resurrection. Hallelujah. What about when the people came and they were hungry? And Jesus looked at the people he has been ministering to since morning. They were hungry and they were tired. And he said, we got to feed them. And Philip told him, he said, the money we have in our account cannot be able to feed these people. Let them go home so they can eat. Jesus said, no, we got to feed them. The Bible says, he said, get some food. And they said, we don't have food. Even we are out of the city. We can't even buy food. But there was a lad. And the lad was the bridge that God was looking for. He had 5 loaves of bread and 2 fishes. When Jesus brought it, that wouldn't have even fed Jesus himself alone. That was too small. But the Bible says, what did he do? He gave thanks. He began to love on God. Father, I thank you for feeding these people. And the miracle began to happen. Many things that we are looking for, God is waiting for us to begin to appreciate him, to thank him for where we have not gotten to. And God will begin to make that place come to pass. In the name of Jesus, we are going to pray in a minute. But I just want to share something to you. When you start to have intimate relationship with God, you will begin to have what we call revelation. Revelation. God will begin to reveal himself to you. God will reveal himself and tell you that I am the God of your grandfather, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. It is through revelation that God will tell you who he is. But you don't get it on the books. You don't get it when you begin to put a demand. Say, oh God, give me a house, give me cars, give me that. The Bible says before you even ask anything, your Father who is in heaven knoweth what you need before you ask. But many times we put asking and demanding and demanding in front of God. And we pray 20 times, all the 20 times, we never say, God, good morning, how are you doing? How is heaven? I thank you for the cloud, the air that I breathe. I thank you for the house I have. I thank you for the little place you have given me. Then we just go and begin to bombard heaven. You might get it, but you might lose it because it will not be sustainable. You don't have a relationship yet. When you develop intimacy with God, God values relationship more than what he can do for you. In the name of Jesus. So John chapter 16, the Bible says in verse 13, the Holy Spirit will show you the things to come. It is through prayer, intimate prayer with God, God will begin to reveal things that will come. Revelation will begin to happen. The Spirit of God begin to show you the things to come, the things that happen. Prayer is a defense. Many times when you are a person of intimacy with God, before negative or positive things happen in your life, you will know it. God will show it to you. God will tell you what will happen. God will give you a way of escape. But a lot of people that go into the presence of God and keep demanding and demanding, you will have trouble. You won't even find out. So you go from one challenge to the next challenge, from another challenge to the next challenge. It is time to say, God, I thank you for life. I thank you for health. I bless you for where I am today. Even though I have not gotten to where I'm going, but I know that you will take me there. Because he that is with me knoweth the way. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. So revelation comes by intimacy. When you go intimate with God, he will reveal himself to you. You can never know God until he reveals himself to you. That's why the Bible said in the book of Daniel, they that know the God that they serve, they shall be strong and they shall do exploit. It is through revelation that you get strong with God, that you begin to walk in a very, very strong manner and in defense in the name of Jesus Christ. And the last thing that God will do for you, it's not the last, but this is what I've just written out now. We just had winter again in summer. I don't know what is going on, but God is all glory and all honor. It's very cold today. We have never had this kind of weather. By this time of the year, I don't know what is going on. Amen. But God knows everything. When you pray in intimate way, God will release the things that you didn't even ask for. Intimacy brings release. Hallelujah. I just want us to read this place before we pray. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus Christ. The book of Isaiah, Mazokotorobo. Isaiah chapter 55. I want you to go and read this Isaiah 55, 1 to 6. By your own. Read it on your own time. Take time and read it again and again and again. I'm just going to brush through it and we are going to pray. Amen. Isaiah chapter 55 and look at verse 1. The Bible said, everyone that thirsts, like being thirsty, he said, come ye to the waters, and he that had no money, come ye, buy and eat. Yea, come, buy wine and milk without money and without price. Everyone that thirsts, Jesus said, come to the water. The water is Jesus, the word. You get that through intimacy. But if you look at verse 5 and 6, I will not even read, let me just read verse 6. The Bible said, and God said there in Isaiah chapter 55, verse 5, he said, behold, thou shalt call a nation. You call one nation. And nations, hallelujah, that knoweth not, that thou shalt call a nation that thou knoweth not. And nations that knew not thee shall run unto thee, because the Lord thy God, and for the Holy One of Israel, for he had glorified you. You shall call one nation, release of blessings. You can be in anywhere, doesn't matter what nation you are in. As I'm standing in America now, I begin to call Africa, Europe, Asia, and the Bible says nations that you know not and did not know you will begin to come to you. It only comes through intimacy. When you have been with God, it's like when you have an intimate relationship with a person. Sometimes when you see the man or the woman after being intimate with their spouse, in the morning they are all smiling, all happy. That is what it is. When you go and reverence God, adore him, don't put a demand on him, ask for anything, just say, Father, I'm here to thank you for all that you have been doing, how you created us, how you kept us, provided for us, be with us. From every challenge that we have gone through, you have always come through to us. As you continue to speak, say, Father, we reverence you. We glorify you. We adore you for who you are, who you represent, and who you will always be. In the name of Jesus, you will start to see the things that you are not asking for will begin to come. God will begin to give you revelation. God will begin to speak. God will confide on you. When you are intimate with God, God will see you as his secret partner. He can tell you things. The Bible says, God said, I will not do this thing without telling my friend Abraham. God will have you as a person he converse with. David, the Bible says, God said, this man is a man after my heart. David will come to God not asking for whatever. He said, God, I thank you, I bless you, I worship you, I reference you. For you are the one that formed the heavens and put it on top of the sea. And he will start to tell God who he is. God already knew who he is, but sometimes he wants to hear it from us. Go and be intimate with God through prayer and see what will happen in your life. God will value you and value everything about you. Your generations shall be set on high and above. The Bible says you will call a nation, and nations you know not, and that the ones that did not know you also, they shall come to you. They shall come to you in the name of Jesus. Mazokotorobo rekata sikataba libaga shikana masakaraba satorobo seketeba mazikataraba shokotobo. Father, I thank you for your son, your daughter. I thank you for my brother, my sister. I thank you for our members, our sons and daughters. I thank you for everyone, partners, colleagues in the ministry, pastors and bishops, apostles, evangelists, prophets, teachers, wherever they are, that are hearing the sound of my voice as we go into intimacy with God throughout this week, and say, God, we love you, we adore you, we worship you, we reference, we glorify you. Let us go and show love to the Almighty, for he is a loving God, but sometimes he expects us to come to him. The Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Sometimes let's just give God things that he didn't ask for from us. Sometimes we just say, Father, I don't have much, but this is what I have. I just want to show you that I love you. Can you just take this in the name of Jesus Christ? And not say, I'm giving you this because of that. It's not a business that you do with God. We are in a relationship. Go and love him, adore him, appreciate him. The prayer of intimacy. In the Bible says the fervent prayer of the righteous availeth much in the presence of God. It's not a prayer of demanding. It's a prayer of intimacy. When you are intimate with God, God will begin to show himself to you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Lord, I want you to offer that to my son and my daughter, everyone that is gathered as they are hearing the sound of my voice. Help us to be intimate with you. Help us to come to you day and night. The Bible said that we should pray not once, but day and night. Jesus said it in Luke chapter 18, look at verse 7. And shall not God avenge his own elect, which cry day and night? Let me tell you something. One time a day is not enough to see God. Come to God day and night. The Bible said the devil goes to God in Revelation chapter 12. He goes and accuses everyone that is a child of God. The devil accuses you day and night. So we should not just let the devil take our lunch, our family anymore. It's time to be intimate. When I talk about intimacy, you get deep with God. Deep calleth unto deep. Hallelujah. You go deep and you stay there. Sometimes you are hours with God. You have never asked him for anything. You just keep loving on him. You just keep adoring him. You just keep worshiping him. You just keep praising him. You just keep doing that. Labogo sakata sakataba, rekata sikotobo, mazikataraba, rekata shanama, mazokoto rekereba, rekata sikotobo sekenema, mizakata sikataba, and you just keep worshiping him. You just keep praising him, and you will see how your life will turn out. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. I want us to live this as a lifestyle. And we pray every day. If you want to know more on intimate prayer, we are praying day and night. But if you want to join us in this marathon, connect with us by this time every day. And also by 7 p.m. Eastern Time. You can check my page where you are now. That's where you have seen me. Or if you go to YouTube, you can search me out also on YouTube, Bishop Gabe. That's all. YouTube.com/Bishop Gabe. And you will get everything that we are telling you. We are a praying people. I'm telling you, we are not talking about church now. We are a praying people because the church of God is without walls. We are the temple of the Holy Ghost. Our body is the temple of God. You are a temple. Wherever you find yourself, let's all come together. For the Bible says, where two or three are gathered in my name, there I am in their midst. I thank you, Lord, Father, for as we have gathered, we will continue to gather and not just come to demand from you, but also come to appreciate you. Help us to be intimate with you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. I just want to pray with you if you are just coming on and you are not a born again, or you have been listening to us, or you have heard the word of God many times in different places, but it has not done on you to be a born again, or somebody have not introduced you to Jesus. I want you to tell you that the only way to be intimate is to receive Christ first by believing in him. I want you to say after me, Lord Jesus Christ, I believe with my heart that you died and resurrected for my sin, and I confess with my mouth that you are my personal Lord and Savior. Jesus Christ, come into my life. Jesus Christ, come into my life. Jesus Christ, come into my life. God bless you. Congratulations again, you are born again. And if you are already in the system, you are already in the kingdom, you are already walking as a servant, you are already fellowshipping with God, let us continue to amplify the will and the word of God. The Bible says, for this is the will of God concerning you in Christ Jesus. God bless you. My name again is Bishop Gabe. I love you with all my heart. Above all, Jesus Christ love you the more. We are going to see today again by 7 p.m. Eastern Time, New York time. Amen. God bless you.